All right, next game up, we're going to have Blackout versus the Raiders. Now, Blackout just came off of a win. You saw they just beat Never Scared. And the Raiders is coming off of a loss to Never Scared. So, listen, at the end of the day, we just talked about Blackout, so we're going to focus on the Raiders. The Raiders' defense has held them down. Similar to what's Blackout doing, their offense has been pathetic. Now, I say Blackout and Raiders' offense is not on the same level. We've seen Blackout's offense fall. Raiders' offense never really jumped into the game. They've been bad from the beginning of the season. And now this is an important game, especially going into the playoffs. Got to show teams that you can score. And taking 3-yard jump balls, 5-yard runs ain't going to help you. This Raiders team is in trouble. They need to show something this game.
Listen, the offense is going to be the key to how far they go in the playoffs. We already know what their defense can do. Always one of the top three defenses in the league. Always. But that doesn't matter if you cannot put up points. Yes, it's a defensive league, but you can't win games if you can't score. It's impossible. So the Raiders, led by Angel, has to figure it out. I don't know what they're going to do because everything that they tried has not worked, but they got to figure it out. This is the game to do that against this Blackout team that has a capable defense that played well, winning a game 7-0, but they got to find a way to put up points. We're ready. Like I just said, the defense is going to do their job. It's all up to the offense to figure out how to get into the end zone. That's the key to this game and how they look forward, how they look moving forward.
All right, we're going to jump into the game. Raiders A player Santana is here. And Blackout obviously still has Kenny here. So we're going to jump right into the game right now with Blackout getting the ball. Alex, with blocking by Shaq, is still sacked by Spud. Spud's been one of the most dangerous weapons on this Raiders defense at the ball giving position. Making plays, definitely getting sacked. Great play by him there. Second out, Alex is blitzed by D'Angelo. Blocked by Shaq, Alex throws Sonique in the gap for a decent game and a first down. Was this a sack? Was Alex sacked?
And on this play, this is a close play right here. As D'Angelo runs in a four rush, he gets behind Alex as he runs for the ball. And it looks like he grazes the back of him, as he makes a tag. These tags with the fingertips or whatever, they can go either way. Unfortunately for them, it wasn't called a sack, and they give up the first down right there. That's a close play, but these things happen. Unfortunately, here they don't get to play there.
Third down, Alex with blocking by Shaq, throws a Kenny in the gap for a nice game. Fourth down, Alex throws it up, tipped by me, picked off by D'Angelo, causing a touchback. Once again, this Raiders defense can play defense, and it caused Alex to make a turnover. Great stop by them.
Listen, this is a great defensive drive right here. The only thing that I would have questioned is I would have rather D'Angelo let go of the ball and don't catch it, because you already know your offense is struggling, so you want to give them the best field positions possible. But that's all that none of that matters. The point is you made the stop and you're able to get your offense on the field.
First down, Angel on four rush is sacked by Lucas. Third down, Angel rolls left and on four rush, throws the lead in the middle for a decent game. Raiders can't get any further, they'll have to punt. Pretty much the same, not being able to move the ball, can't even really extend plays, and they've been punting more than like any other team in the league. It's frustrating for their defense to make a big stop, and your offense gives it right back.
And the thing about it is they're incapable of getting more than what the defense is allowing them to give, and because of that, that's one of the reasons why they're forced to punt all the time. They have to find ways to get by the defense and get some bigger plays in this. Yes, this one play by Meek was able to move the ball, but it's far from the yardage that you need to get, at least to keep the drive going. They need to get bigger plays in this, otherwise they're going to be punting all game.
Second down, Alex on four rush, throws a Breezy on the sideline, who makes the catch for a nice game and a first down. Was he out of bounds? What do you think of the play?
And this play right here, it looks like you can see he's able to hold the ball out of bounds. But as there's a player in between the view as he lands to make the catch, it's hard to see if his foot was in bounds for the catch or if he was out of bounds. So I guess it goes by what the ruling on the field is, and the ruling on the field is the catch for the first down.
I love the effort. This is the Breezy we need to see all the time, because if he gets open, Alex is going to find him. Alex Santos and Mace open on the sideline for a nice game. If you look here, D'Angelo leaves the sideline. Third down, Alex throws the meat in the gap into the 10-yard line. Fourth down, Alex finds Brandon in the front of the end zone for the touchdown. D'Angelo points him out, but leaves him open as the defense is in man. Nino gets the extra point. 7-0, Blackout finally scores.
And look at this drive. The first thing that we said before, in that last game, the guys got to get involved. The first play we show, you see Breezy get involved making that big catch for the first down. Then you see Mace get involved with that pass for a nice game. Then you see Meek getting them to the 10-yard line. And then finally, Brandon, the guy that we haven't seen in the end zone all season because he's been hurt, finally gets back into the end zone. So all of these guys are guys that we've been saying that needs to be a factor on the offense, and they were all a factor in this one drive, and that's how they get into the end zone.
Raiders get the ball back. Angel is blitzed and sacked by Macho. Second down, Angel on 4 rush. Throws his spot on the sideline, almost picked off by Breezy. After getting the first down, Angel with 3 passes here in the gap for a nice game, get him to the 20-yard line. Fourth down, Angel throws a leak in the back of the end zone. Incomplete. Turnover on downs. Once again, the Raiders get stopped again. Even though they will move the ball, can't come up with any points to get stopped.
And I'm just going to say, like I said the last drive, they're moving the ball, but they're moving the ball in the pace that the defense is allowing them to. If you saw the last drive, they were able to get 3 passes, but they only get to the 20-yard line, and it's fourth down from there. That is an unsuccessful drive because now you have to force your way into the end zone from the 20-yard line. The defense did their job, so you got to find a way to get further into the defensive territory. If not, they're pretty much going to have full control and they're able to stop you just like they did just here.
Blackout gets the ball back. Second down, Alex with Blackout from Shaq throws a knee on the sideline for next game. Third down, Alex with Blackout by Shaq, still sacked by Spud. You look at Shaq's flag for holding, it's going to be declined. Blackout has to punt. Tell me about the hold. Is that a hold?
Yes, it was, because Shaq got beat by Spud. And the thing about Shaq is he's able to block most of the guys that come his way. But Spud is a different type of player. He finds ways to swim around the defense, swim around the block, and he's able to get the sack. This time, this is the second sack of the game, and Shaq had no choice but to even try to hold and see if he get away with it. Unfortunately, he doesn't, and that is a clear sack by Spud. Great defense by Spud there.
Raiders can't score before the half, and that's going to be 7-0 Blackout.
And this is the frustrating thing about the Raiders. Their defense is doing everything that they're supposed to do. They're holding this Blackout team to only 7 points in the first half. They gave up one, but that's fine. Your offense has to answer. And the fact that your offense was either punted or stopped once, twice, 3 times in the first half. They had the ball 3 times, wasn't able to get into the end zone, not once. That's an unsuccessful game on their offense. But it's more of the same for this offense. If you're not able to respond and take advantage of what the defense is doing for you, you're going to lose almost every single game like this, and that's exactly what's happened so far in the first half.
If I'm Blackout, I'm not worrying about this team because they can't score points. We've seen them struggle all season with scoring points. And even though our offense hasn't been great, we have the best defense in the league. So as long as we have that and we can keep – we got our – we're up, we're going to hold this lead because we don't fear the Raiders' offense at all. We're going to jump into the second half. After getting the first down, Angel throws deep to Santana in the gap, off target, incomplete. Second down, Angel with blocking from Rob, throws a leak in the gap, who runs for a nice game. Third down, Angel throws the ice on the sideline, picked off by Dez, giving the ball back to Blackout. If you look here, Elvis was open short, Angel with a bad feed, and turns the ball over.
And this is you missing your check down receiver and forcing the pass. More of the same. Angel not reading the play, reading the defense, and finding his guys open in the gaps. When you miss plays like this, it just shows why you've been struggling all season. Not only is these receivers not able to get through the defense, but now it's Angel missing guys that's open. If you're not able to connect the offense, this is exactly what's going to happen, and they end up throwing an interception, pretty much getting stopped yet again in this game.
Blackout gets the ball back. Fourth down at the 45-yard line. 2 short passes. Alex with blocker from Shaq throws to Nino in the gap for a nice game, picking up the first down. Nino's flag for person, 15 yards back. Blackout gets the ball back. We're going to be on fourth down at the 45-yard line. After 2 short passes, Alex with a blocking by Shaq throws to Nino in the gap. getting him a nice game and a first down, but he's called for cursing 15 yards back. Now listen, that's gonna hurt because now they're moving forward just to move back. Bad time to curse. Definitely hurt them on this play here. Alex and with two short passes for a decent game. Fourth down at the 20-yard line. Alex on four rush, throws a Mace in the front of the end zone. Mace gets one hand on it, incomplete. Turnover on downs. Mace believe he was held. Tell me what you saw on that.
I don't think it's enough contact to really merit the hold, especially on a play like that, across the play. So, you know, a lot of refs are not going to necessarily throw a bailout flag if they see contact like that or whatever. I don't think it's enough. At the end of the day, they didn't really have much of a shot to get into the end zone here anyway. And I think that big flag there by Nino, who took away that big play that he just made, is what hurt this drive right here, because they have to be fourth down right at near the 50-yard line. There's but so much you could do after that, and they give up they turn over the ball there.
Angel with three passes to Elvis in the gap for a nice game, getting him to the 45-yard line. Pass down. Angel with blocking from Elvis and Lee. Angel runs and reaches the ball over the line to get the first down. Everybody went crazy to say he was short. He ended up getting called for the first down. What do you think of the play?
And I think if you look here, first of all, this is a hard angle for us to, you know, look at this here. And this is would be a play that would be challenged in the playoffs. But if you look here, it looks like right as he gets tagged, I'm slowing down best I can. It looked like he just gets the ball over the line for the first down. I don't know why he didn't run right away to get the first down, but he keeps it close. Fortunately for him, he's able to get it by the end zone. I mean, he's able to get it by the first down just in time to the drive going.
Second down, Angel scrambles on four rush and gets sacked by Lucas. If you look here, his butt is opening the gap. Raiders can't move the ball anymore, and they're going to have to punt with 2 minutes left in the game. You went through all that just to get a first down, and you still can't move the ball. This offense is terrible, and they're showing it in this game. Alex gets the ball back on four rush, runs for a nice game. Third down, Alex is blitzed by Joel, blocked by Shaq. Alex throws a Kenny in the gap, who runs for a nice game. Fourth down, Alex on four rush, throws a Brandon in the middle for a first down. End of the game, Blackout comes away with a win, 7-0.
And eventually, that last drive there on defense for the Raiders is just this. That's a hint of what may happen in the playoffs if their offense struggles this way. Eventually, their defense is going to fall apart at the end, and they're not able to hold throughout the game. And as you saw here, they gave up two huge plays to give Blackout the opportunity to get the first down to end the game. So regardless of how good your defense is, if you cannot score, there's no way for them to win the game for you. You expect the defense to get the interception and score for you? It's not going to happen. So you got to make plays on offense. Otherwise, you're going to lose close games like this. This may be a reflection of what may happen in the playoffs if they don't fix their offense. I don't see how they're going to do that at this point because this is pretty much the end of the season. But that's something that they have to figure on their own.
I get on both teams real quick. Listen, I won two games that they had to win. But this offense still have problems. Now, if they can get to the offense that they did when they scored in this game, getting all those guys involved, this team can be dangerous in the playoffs. I'm not worrying about their defense. They have the number one defense in the league. They have a great pressure. Now you see Lucas getting involved. They got a lot of guys that can make plays on the defensive side of the ball. If they don't find a way to turn around offensively, if they ever get into a shootout, they're going to be in trouble. So Tone has to figure out a way how him and Alex can stay in a rhythm offensively, but they can move the ball and definitely put up some points. On the other side of the ball, Raiders' offense is pathetic.
Yeah.
It's pathetic. It's pretty bad.
I just wanted to show some optimism, but you just said it pretty much.
No, they're pathetic. And they're going into the playoffs with a pathetic offense. As you saw in those scores that we put up on the screen, the defense started not being able to shut people out, not being able to stop everything, and they lost. This defense is going to get frustrated of not only that the Raiders' offense is getting stopped, it's how they're getting stopped. They cannot move the ball. They're punting. They can't pick up first downs. That's problems, especially going into the playoffs. Everybody in the playoffs is going to feel that as long as you know the Raiders' offense can't score any points, have a shot to win. It's nothing they can do now. Angel's just starting quarterback. You need to start running plays that he likes that can work for him. I don't know if you have to run the ball. I don't know if you have to throw screens. But you got to do stuff to make him a little more comfortable because right now it's getting very, very ridiculous.
Like you said, there's but so much they can do at this point. The thing about them is a lot of guys have, like you said, they have to make their job, the job of Angel easy for them. They have to find a way to get open. They have to find a way to, they even doing running plays, something that they really haven't tried to do. They got to do more than what they've been doing because it's not working. I haven't seen them really take too many downfield shots as much as possible because Angel's a lot of times worried about the rush coming in, you know, so. You know, Rob has to step up in the block, give Angel some more time. These guys got to find ways to break away from the defense, and they got to find ways to get more than what the defense is allowing them to get. If they continue to move the ball the way that they are, they're going to continue to get shut out, and they're going to be pretty much one and done in the playoffs, no matter how good their defense is, because they still have one of the best defenses in the league, but none of that matters because the defense isn't going to be the main factor scoring the football. So it doesn't really matter at the end of the day.
All right, we're going to wrap this one up with Blackout coming to win over the Raiders 7-0. Be right back. Next game up, you're going to have DG versus UTF. DG's coming off of a win to 99. UTF is coming off of a loss to Rep City. Now, listen, at the end of the day, I know I talked a lot about Chuck being on the decline. He's had a great season. They've won a few games in a row. And I believe this team right now is third in scoring. So he's definitely turned this team around to what they were last season. And he's definitely doing it with a limited attack. Bones has been hurt. Lou has stopped coming. Trev ended up leaving. Randy ended up leaving. These are guys that they all thought that was going to be in a roster. You know, Megatron is not the Megatron of old. Timmy's not the Timmy of old. So, you know, he's been going through his main guys. Cable, who's playing well early in the season, he's hurt. So he's been playing with a limited offensive attack. And for him to be third in scoring is something to be said. Shout to him. Shout to Pans putting his team together, and they're going in the right direction.
And one thing I could say is regardless of all the weapons that they lost, there's certain guys that have been stepping up on this team. Even though Megatron is not the Megatron of old, he had a couple of plays in the last game. He's been stepping up his game. Timmy every now and then has a big play here and there. One person that's really been stepping up on this team is Dash. He's been caught answering the call on both sides of the field, making a lot of big plays and being a main target for Chuck on offense. And it's one of the reasons why they're able to keep the drives going and get into the end zone. Chuck, you know, it's what can you say about Chuck? You said that he showed signs of still having things in the tank. He's able to actually make plays as long as guys step up and make, you know, and play for him. That's exactly what they're doing, and that's why they're on the winning streak right now.
And on the other side, UTF, they haven't scored in a few games. Their offense has looked very much like a shattered form of stuff, more arguing, more frustration, and Jeremy has not really been the quarterback that they thought he was in the beginning of the season. This team wins this game, and that's all thrown out the window, and they can block in the number one seed, which gives them a bye. So listen, they lost three in a row. It doesn't matter because if they win this game, they could get a first-round bye, which is something they really want to have, especially since the Monarchs just lost early in the day.
And the thing about this guy, Jeremy, is, yeah, he's been having a couple bad games, you know, in the last three games, I would say. But anytime when he's able to flick that switch and get hot, he's dangerous. And one thing about Jeremy is if you give him opportunity to take off, take off running, he's going to keep the drive going with his feet alone. I believe the only person better than him at running this season has been Shannon. So when you give him the opportunity to use his feet to extend a drive, it's going to make this offense that much better. And that's exactly what they're going to need in this game if they want to come away with a win.
All right, we're going to jump right into the game with UTF getting the ball. First down, Jeremy throws deep to Charles in the gap. Caught in the end zone for the touchdown. If you look here, Chris steps up, leaving them open. And at 6-0, UTF scores.
And I'm going to look at, when we look at this play, as you see Charles running down the field, one thing you got to understand is if Jeremy is given a target downfield, he will take it. And that's exactly what he does here. But if you look at Chris, he points out the corner to guard this person here, and he steps up. So nobody's going to guard Charles. Nobody's stepping down the field to guard Charles. I believe that that's Juice who goes to the corner to guard the receiver here. But Juice had the best opportunity to go after Charles downfield, but because he's called to guard the sideline, nobody's able to pick up Charles, and he's left wide open for that touchdown pass here.
After getting the first down, Chuck on four rush rolls right and throws a Michael in the gap. With contact from Mamba, the pass is dropped. Michael got to make this catch. Guys are not going to take it easy on him because he's young and he's still learning the game. They're going to beat him up as anyone else he makes the drop here. Third down with blocker from Hollywood. Chuck throws a Megatron on the sideline, getting him to the 12-yard line. Fourth down, Chuck on four rush throws a West in the back of the end zone, knocked away by Charles. Turnover on downs, and UTF is able to stop DG. That is a great stop by this defense.
That drop by Michael with the contact, I believe that that's what kind of dictated the drive there. And then after this big play by Megatron, they're not able to get any closer. All you have to do is, like I said, the first down pass, the third down play, whatever. If you're able to make stops on these key plays, you're able to make a stop, and that's exactly what this defense does here.
Jeremy gets the ball back. He's going to roll left and throw to Charles on the sideline, who pitches it to Frankie. Frankie runs in the gap for a nice game. This team is getting the momentum, moving the ball. Great play there. Second down, Jeremy throws short to Frankie, who pitches it back to Jeremy. Jeremy runs in the middle for a big gain in the first down. This is the thing that this team can do. We've seen them beat you with kick returns. We've seen pick sixes. This team can do pretty much everything. And when they're moving the ball this way, getting everybody involved, they're even more dangerous. Jeremy gets the ball on four rush. He throws a Mamba in the gap, picked off by Dash. Dash runs all the way to the 20-yard line. It's falling out. Great interception. Huge mistake by Jeremy.
And the thing about these first two plays that we showed, these were two unpredictable plays that caught the defense off guard, and they got some big yardage from it. But if you look at this play, they go from being unpredictable to be totally predictable because Dash is reading that play, and because Mamba's staying stationary, it gives Dash the opportunity to make a play on that easy throw, and he's able to get some big yardage after the catch, getting him to the 20-yard line. Huge defensive play by Dash.
Third and goal, after two short passes, Chuck finds Dash in front of the end zone for the touchdown. West gets the extra point, 7-6, DG.
And this whole drive, from the defensive play up until finding him in the end zone, this was Dash all the way, making that big defensive play, getting him to field position, and then ultimately getting open in front of the end zone for Chuck to find him for the touchdown. So this is Dash stepping up, and he's been doing it all season. I believe, in my opinion, he deserves to go to the All-Star game because he's been showing that consistency. No matter how many times you see him make plays on the field, he's always a big player for DG, and he shows it here in this one drive.
On the kickoff, DG's flag for cursing, 15 yards, 4 and out right now. Second down, Jeremy with blocker from Frankie. Jeremy throws to Charles in the corner of the end zone, caught but out of bounds, incomplete. UTF can't get any closer, and they end up turning over the ball. That is a huge stop by DG, especially having a penalty on that drive. That is a great stop by them, slowing down his UTF passing attack.
And this is UTF not taking advantage of that flag. They got 15 yards. Even though they rushed, they got some decent yardage on the kick return. They get 15 yards on top of that on the curse, and they're still not able to find a way to get into the end zone. This because they are not finding passes in the gaps. They're starting to be predictable. Those big plays that they got in that last drive, it seems like they're incapable of doing those again. And because of that, DG is able to make a big stop for the turnover here.
After getting the first down, Chuck on four rushes, sacked by Randy. Last play of the half, Chuck on four rushes, sacked by Buto, taking us into the half, 7-6, DG. Great sacks by this UTF defense. Listen, one thing I give about Buto, he's going to die on that field for a scene. Big sack. And Randy is up there for a defensive play here. You see him get interceptions in the secondary. Now we've seen him move to the giver position and make a key sack. This guy is definitely a defensive player. 7-6, DG with the lead.
I believe that they had the opportunity given to them by that one interception. If you take away that one interception, I'm not so hot on the offense because they got stopped in the first drive here. after getting the first down, they stagnated. They couldn't move the ball. So they have to find ways to get the offense to move the ball a little bit better than this. UTF has a capable defense, but this DG offense has to figure out how to drive, and how to get through it. If they don't, they're going to have a long game because UTF is an energetic team, and if you get them hot, they're going to be a tough team to stop. They have to figure out how to score early in the second half.
All right, we're going to jump into the second half. After getting the first down, Chuck throws the juice in the middle for a decent game. Butoh's flag for a personal foul, 15 yards. What do you think of the play?
I think that it was a personal foul because, you know, he goes, tries to make a tag, but he uses forearm. So that's clearly an illegal contact play. Unfortunately, that's not a play that they need on defense, and that gives DG the extra yardage that they need to keep the drive going.
Third and goal, Chuck finds Megatron in front of the end zone for the touchdown. Gaka intercepts the extra point, but it's 13-6 DG. And listen, Butoh gets mad sometimes. He always say, well, when other guys do stuff, if I was to do it, I'll be a flag. This is a reputation he's building against himself. That was a forearm. That's not straight tag, and he's refs are watching him because he's known to do that. The guy plays 110%. He's not dirty, but sometimes he plays overly aggressive. That penalty cost him because it gave this DG offense, who's good at scoring, better field position, and he ended up scoring again. During the kickoff, Dev runs through the gap on the sideline all the way into the end zone for the touchdown, 13-12. UTF jumps right back into the game. If you look here, DG only have five guys on the play. That is a huge one. Got to put that on coaching. That's on Pam's. He got to make sure everybody's on the field. They didn't have enough guys. And Dev, who's one of the most dangerous kick returners, aside from Shannon, can make you pay, and he does here.
And I'm going to say two things on this play here. First of all, there's no way that you're throwing off the ball. First of all, it's one thing if you're receiving the ball and you don't have enough guys on the field on time. But you're the one kicking, so you have the opportunity to make sure you have the guys lined up for this play. They don't, that shows that they were clearly not paying attention, and they gave away a big play for the score here. That's unfortunate, because on a close game like this, this is not a play you want to give up. So right here, this is a missed opportunity. This could have been a good defensive drive. We'll never know, because they give away the kick return because they don't have enough guys to make the stop here. Few close plays to make the tags and whatever, but when you only have five guys, it's but so much is going to happen, and Dev takes advantage and gets it to the end zone.
Chuck gets the ball on second down. He scrambles on four rushes, sacked by Butoh. After getting the first down, Chuck throws a Michael in the gap for a decent game. Third down, Chuck with blocker from Hollywood throws deep in the front of the end zone, knocked away by Charles. Michael was open short. Chuck missed him. Fourth down, Chuck throws the juice in the front of the end zone. Incomplete. Turnover on downs. Great stop by UTF, keeping the game close.
And that huge third down play is what did it right there. Chuck trying to find Weston's play here. Charles is able to read the play and knock it away. These are key plays right here that you have to make if you're UTF defense. But that's exactly what they've been doing. When they're not giving away flags, when they're not giving away calls, their defense is able to hold. And this is yet another stop by this UTF defense.
Jeremy gets the ball. He's with blocking by Frankie. Runs in the middle for a nice game, getting him to the 40-yard line. Jeremy's been a great runner this season. You got to give him love for his legs. The guy's making plays. After getting the first down, Jeremy, with a block by Frankie, runs on the sideline for a nice game to the 20-yard line. He is killing them on the ground. Frankie has been their best blocker, better than G, better than anybody else that he has. Frankie has been blocking the best. Great play there. Second down. Jeremy throws a Mamba open in the front of the end zone for the touchdown. If you look here, Chris at safety's playing too short, leaving him open. Mamba gets the extra point, 20-13. UTF takes the lead.
And I'm going to say this. This was two mistakes that gave away points by this guy, Chris at safety. They have to make an adjustment because Chris not only is not communicating properly, but he's playing too short, not reading the field. Because he's playing short, of course, Jeremy's going to make this play. Look at how easy he's able to find Mamba in front of the end zone. And this is a quick play, not even 3 seconds and the ball is thrown. That's because Jeremy, right off the line, saw the lineup of the defense and took advantage. Chris got to know that at safety, you are the last line of defense. When you're playing that short, the offense is going to take advantage. That's exactly what happens to give this UTF team the lead here.
After getting the first down, Chuck with the ball, the clock is running out. Chuck on four rush, runs for a decent game. Third down, Chubb on four rush, throws a track in the gap, and it's dropped by track star. Huge drop. Remember, 20-13, fourth down. Chubb on four rush, throws a Megatron in the front of the end zone, picked off by Charles, who runs it all the way back into the end zone for the touchdown. UTF comes away with the win, 26-13, and they lock the number one seed.
And I believe that one play, listen, I'm not going to say that it's all one play's fault or anything like that, but this one play by track on that third down play on offense is what killed them here. Because if he would have made that catch, I believe there would have been at least at the 7-yard line with opportunity to score. But because of that, Chuck is forced to make this play right here and it's intercepted. You have to make this catch. This is a routine catch, a big catch here that you drop. That's unfortunate because on defense, they gave away 2 touchdowns, the same player making mistakes here, and UTF was able to take advantage. You take away these 3 plays here, this is a completely different game. The plays on defense where they gave them touchdowns, and this play here where track dropped the touch on a big play on third down. Again, this could have been a different game for DG, and I believe that those 3 key plays is what made UTF have the opportunity to come away with this win here.
I agree, and that's why sometimes you got to give Chuck a little more props because he's not playing with the most talent he had. Track got to make that catch, but you know what? Track is not really an offensive player. He made the UFL All-Star a few years back as a defensive player. So that's a catch you got to make, but he was open. Chuck is going to throw to the open guy. Listen, yeah. This offense has been carried by Chuck. They lack weapons completely, and you saw it. And the thing about UTF is when they get momentum, they make plays. A lot of mistakes came with this drop here. The kickoff that they only have 5 guys. Was it a hole? Yes, it probably was a hole, but you only have 5 guys anyway. So you had mistakes and you expected that UTF was going to make, and they didn't. And they made you pay. And Jeremy killed them with his legs. He ran all day and it was not able to stop his running attack. Mamba got involved in a passing game. Listen, at the end of the day, if UTF stays playing like this, they can do it all the way to the championship game.
Yeah.
The question is what UTF team you're going to see. And for DG, listen, they got to have players make plays because you sleeping on these teams, you're going to go home easy early in the first round. So that's definitely something that they got to pay attention to. Track got to talk to Pams. They got to figure it out because this team has a lot of flaws, and them flaws can cost games. We're going to wrap this one up and wrap up the show. Sorry, but at this game, we had a little mic issue. So if I sound a little different, that's why. We're going to have another show coming out showing our thoughts of the playoff matchup. So we're not going to get into the playoff matchup this one because we'll have a show. The league is off Saturday. So we're going to record another show. And before the playoffs start, we'll have another one to show y'all. So we want to thank y'all. We want to wish everybody a blessed and happy new year. Enjoy the week off, guys. We'll see y'all guys next week. UTF, I'm sorry. UTF with the win over DG, 26-13. We're going to wrap up the show. On behalf of Real Tough Talk, I'm Stephen J, my partner Ghost. We want to wish y'all guys a very blessed Christmas, which we did already.
Yeah.
I messed up, but I'll keep it going. Happy New Year. Much blessed, guys. We'll see y'all dudes next year on the new show. We'll see y'all. Have a good time, guys. We'll see y'all. Be safe. All right.